Valley, which is the land of Gloria and Saldúa. And so I was sad to leave El Paso, but I loved moving to the Valley, and I feel very grateful to live in another border community. And so part of the way that I was able to learn the new borderland was to go out into the community, and I made a lot of pictures, I made lots of little videos, and this is before we had these fancy iPhones, so I want to apologize. I'm going to show you some shaky videos. You're going to feel like it's the Blair Witch Project, if any of you have seen it, or just me. And I wasn't like intending to make this anything beautiful, it was just like, I call it my poetry research. So, okay, so this is in Brownsville. And this is the person who is near the wall is Scott Nichol, and he is a member of the Sierra Club. And he is here going to show you, this is a brand new border wall. And so some people call them fences. This I call a wall. And he's just going to show you really quickly how easy it is to get over it. So. So when I first moved to the Valley, I was so amazed because I had been living in El Paso where there's already lots of fencing, and but in the Valley there weren't any that I could see, and I was so amazed that you could see the river so beautifully. And so I spent a lot of time out in nature taking a lot of images here, you know, just even silly things like these flags, you know, I'm like buying tacos and looking out the window. I'm a very visual person, and so a lot. Okay, so here is where, I'll show you this in a little while. I'm going to turn this part off. I wanted to show you the river, especially this place a little bit. So this was in Brownsville, but the part here by the river, this is, I believe I took this, maybe near West Lipo. Rio Rico Bluffs, I think. But also, if you go a little bit further down, you're in the Santa Ana National Wildlife Refuge, and that is where I wrote this poem, this first poem. So this piece is the first poem in my new collection with the river on her face. And I say that I wrote it, but I was riding my bike through the wildlife refuge near the river. And if you're like me, you get all these thoughts and you don't have any access to paper and pencil. And so I got into the habit of recording myself on a recorder because I was thinking all these thoughts as I was riding my bike. That's before I had kids and I had more time. It's important for me to mention that the Santa Ana National Wildlife Refuge is now on the list of places that the new administration wants to build a border wall. And at the time that I wrote this, there were border walls going up in other parts of the community, but not this National Wildlife Refuge. So I wrote this without any knowledge of that happening. And it's you. It is you. I know it's you. It's you and you and you, not one. You. You. You in the bee. You in the leaves bitten. You in the bitten leaves. You, you in the holes in the bitten leaves, in the absences, in the leaves. You, you in the absences of the leaves, of the leaving. You in the absences, you here. You in the acrylic, you in the acrylic smell of carrizo, in the wind, in the tree trunk. You in the red ants, in the dirt dome. You if I look up, you if I look down. If I sit on the tree trunk and feel the earth rumbling below through the roots, because the wind and river water stir the roots to stir below and below, somewhere deep beneath, then I know that it is you and you are earth, and the earth is nothing more than you. And you are the dragonfly with dotted wings, you flying into the leaves, the branches, the upright branches, upright, you are upright. You in the spaces between the shadows of the trees on this dirt road. You in the shadows and spaces, in the shadows and snowflake spaces, in the branch shade. You in the burnt sugar deaths, you. 30 hawks flying over the river, earth cupping water, wind blowing river in the opposite direction, sun lit up river, sun white silvers the river. Is this what it's like to feel you as water, carrizo swaying water, struggling upstream in the sun? Is that you in a thousand silver rivers? What I meant to say is that a long-billed thrasher didn't fly away. What I meant to say is that I am not you, I am not you, I don't mean to suggest suggest that we are the same. We're not. That's why I like you. It's vampiric the way the mosquitoes bite. It's vampiric the way they find and bite only me, it seems. It's vampiric the way that I am thinking about you. A brave berry spat out with seeds and chapulinas, scat out seeds and chapulinas. And I smell the pile of bobcat scat, the bobcat scat, and walked over chalky gray feather mouse, mouse like scat, mouse transformed into shit. Feathery feathers, and it leaves a chalk stain, an outline of a chalk stain, and then a turquoise dragonfly flew right overhead. A bright turquoise dragonfly flew right overhead. Red dragonfly, red cardinals, red damsel, red ruby spot, cha-cha-laka, cha-cha-laka. Tree branch in the road, thought it was an indigo. Tree branch in the road, thought it was an indigo. Tree branch in the road, I thought it was an indigo snake. Whole rat shat out, a whole rat flattened out. Whole rat shat out, whole rats flattened out. Yes, whole rats, whole little cotton rats. What I forgot to say is that violence passed there, blood spilled here. Red dragonfly, little hawks, little hakal, little mud house. Blood spilled there. I said violence, violence happened here. A pile of seed berries gone straight through a coyote, javelina, fox, raccoon. I wanted expired, expelled. I want earth to expire it and extol something new, you. So I really fell in love with the land. There was a lot of stress in academia, for those of you who are connecting. And going to these natural spaces really helped me to sort of unwind from it all, but also really just helped me to process where I was living and things that I was feeling. And so I feel really grateful to the Wildlife Refuge, and now it's just really sad because they want to build a wall there, and they're going to build it where the refuge begins. And so the plan apparently is to like cut down all the trees and everything that's there before you get to the river. And so that they can be able to, you know, see who's coming across. And I don't even think a lot of people cross there actually. And so that's the plan right now, and that's what we're resisting there in the valley. It's a really beautiful place. So they call the land the Monte there, where all the mesquite trees and everything. And about 95% of it has been removed in the last like 100 or so years. And so there's only like 5% of this kind of land left in the valley due to numerous reasons, especially farming. So if y'all can lend your voices to help us out, that would be great. So this next piece is Gone Down River. And it's a really short piece. I was reading The Hour of the Star, which is a great little book by Clarice Lispector. And it was translated into English. And it's kind of a half of a found poem, so part of the words towards the end are lifted from her, but kind of condensed. Have any of you ever like borrowed somebody's book and they have like underlining in it and highlights? And if it's somebody that you know you kind of like, well then you read, like, I don't know, it becomes even more interesting, right? So that's Gone Down River. Yes, down river to the beach party, the hour of the star. Your underlinings, as if finding them later, rolled up in the sheets. The pleasure of the text and me humming sweet nothingness. Damned and don't know it. Consciousness, I am.